Hello class 8, let's start our online geography class. We are continuing chapter 5, Natural and Man-made Disaster. Through my previous classes, I already discussed about the natural and man-made disasters and about disaster management too. Today, I'll discuss about role of the government and some case studies which I gave you for your project work. As I told you about the disaster management in India and disaster management operations, you know, it is very important. It includes different phases of action. The steps are, first step is response and relief. Immediate measures taken up to reduce the number of casualties after a disaster. Okay? And next step is rehabilitation and reconstruction. This include the operations that are taken up to bring back the normal conditions of living in the affected areas. It is very essential to bring back the normal condition of living. Okay? So it is the second phase. Rehabilitation and reconstruction. First one, as I told you, response and relief. Second phase is rehabilitation and reconstruction. And third stage is mitigation. This includes actions that are taken up to minimize the impact of a disaster. Okay? They can be either structural mitigation measures or maybe non-structural mitigation measures. So, firstly, the structural mitigation measures. It includes building cyclone shelters in coastal areas. Actually, coastal areas are usually cyclone prone areas. So, building cyclone shelters is very essential there. And earthquake resistant buildings in earthquake prone areas, or building embankments for flood proofing a village. Okay, so three structural mitigations are building cyclone shelters in coastal areas and building embankments in flood prone village. Okay. And next is non-structural mitigation measures. It includes awareness building, mapping disaster prone areas, mock drill by disaster management teams. It is very much important, mock drill by disaster management team. In every institution and every buildings, there must be mock drill by the disaster management teams. That in any case of such disasters, all persons can rescued. And fourth phase is preparedness. This should be done in advance by the local residents, NGOs, state and country to cope with that disaster better. Mental preparedness and physical preparedness both are very much important. Disasters can be avoided if adequate preparedness is conducted, planned and strengthened. Here you can see the diagram which shows the steps of disaster management. First one is response and relief, then rehabilitation and reconstruction, then prevention through mitigation measures and preparedness. Okay. Now, I am telling you about the role of the government. Actually, the responsibility to organize rescue, relief and rehabilitation lies with the state governments. And the central government supplements the efforts of the state government by providing financial and logistic support in case of major disasters. I told you before that the central government provide thus all the supports, but the main function, that is organized rescue, relief and rehabilitation, lies with the state government. And logistic support include providing aircraft, boats, central paramilitary forces, national disaster relief forces, medical relief and infrastructure facilities. These are all logistic support which is provided, always provided by the central government. Okay. Next is nodal agencies responsible for disaster management. As I told you before, the nodal agencies, that is in national nodal ministries, that in national sphere. Floods, in case of floods, Ministry of Water Resources, and in case of cyclone, Indian Meteorological Department. In case of chemical disasters, Ministry of Environment and Forest. In case of railway accidents, Ministry of Railways. In case of airway accidents, Ministry of Civil Aviation. And mine accidents, Department of Mines. And industrial disasters, Ministry of Labor. And in case of fire, National Disaster Response Force and Civil Defense under the Ministry of Home Affairs. Okay. As I told you, in the national level, the Ministry of Home Affairs is responsible for coordinating all disaster management related activities. Okay. Now I'll tell you about some case studies which I already told you about to prepare the project. Okay. So I'll telling you next the case studies. First one is floods in Assam. You know, Assam is a unique region with rich biodiversity. And the mighty Brahmaputra River, Assam is located in Brahmaputra Valley. And the mighty Brahmaputra flows majestically through the heart of this state. But at times, it causes huge loss to the land and its people due to overflooding. So let us learn about the causes for the flooding in Assam. The natural causes are the Himalayan rivers, you know, carry a lot of sediments which make the river bed shallow. These sediments make the river bed shallow, okay? As the Brahmaputra is also a Himalayan river, it flows through the entire length of Assam and its origin in Tibet. When too much ice melts in the source region, the water level of this river rise. For that, floods occur. And the thing is, Assam also receives heavy rainfall from the Bay of Bengal branch of the southwest monsoon. This also results in an increase in the volume of water in the Brahmaputra River. And floods, you know, frequently occurred in this state. There are several instances of disastrous floods. Okay, so I'm telling you that here the natural causes. The Himalayan rivers carry a lot of sediments, which I told you, which make the river bed shallow, as the sediments are deposited here in this course of river. The river deposited the sediments, so the river bed became shallow. And massive rainfall in the northeast during monsoons, as I told you before, that the branch of Bay of Bengal causes heavy rainfall here. And earthquakes have often resulted in landslides which block the rivers and change their courses. And the Brahmaputra river has a tendency to shift its course. These all are the natural causes. Okay, in your project work, you can mention any three causes from this. Okay, any three from this. And anthropogenic causes. What is anthropogenic? Actually, it is man-made causes. These are all are man-made causes. The first one is deforestation. Deforestation over large areas has led to soil erosion. You know, root of the plants hold the soil tightly. So, plants can prevent soil erosion. But in case of deforestation, then the soil erosion occurs largely and the large areas has led to soil erosion. And next is shifting cultivation. In these areas, shifting cultivation is very common. Shifting cultivation in the adjoining hills has led to soil erosion. Same as before, the deforestation cause soil erosion. Same way, shifting cultivation causes soil erosion, because in case of shifting cultivation, all the plants are cut down to make this the land agricultural land. The heavy load of silt is deposited in river beds. Okay. Wetlands were known to hold the excess water during monsoons. These are reclaimed for agricultural settlement and industrial purposes. Some are infested with weeds. Next, rivers are choked with waste materials and sewage and are unable to carry the rainwater. The construction of roads, railways, and embankments has changed the course of rivers. Okay. Now, the impact of flooding. The Brahmaputra and its tributaries flows from the Himalayas carrying a huge volume of water and a large load of sediments. During monsoons, as the volume increases, the river's power to carry the silt increases. Clear to you? During monsoon, volume of water increases and the power of the river to carry the silts, which the silts which they eroded from the mountainous region, that is also increases. The rivers are found to swallow their banks, and as a result, number of villages are submerged. And you know, Majuli is the largest river island, which is located in the Brahmaputra river. It is the largest river island of the world. Majuli, always remember, it is the Majuli river island is under the threat of breaking up into two pieces. Its existence is doubtful in the future. Shifting cultivation in Meghalaya, North Kachar Hills and Nagaland has led to heavy soil loss. Heavy soil erosion occurs due to shifting cultivation in Meghalaya, North Kachar Hills and Nagaland. As a result, the alluvial plain where paddy is cultivated is often flooded. And you know, the Kaziranga National Park, which is the only habitat for the Indian one-horned rhinoceros, is under severe threat of existence due to floods. The severe flood in 1988 ravaged the Kaziranga National Park and claimed the lives of 85 rhinos. Floods in Assam usually cut off communication with the rest of the region. As this region is overflooded, then the communication is also cut off with the rest of the part region. As the highways and railways are submerged, the Himalayan slopes are the worst affected areas. Firstly, because of landslides and then floods. The embankments that were built to save people from overflooding rivers finally prevented the rainwater from flowing into the river and caused further flooding in the plains. Survival after floods is really difficult. People are poverty stricken after losing all their belongings. There is a huge economic loss as life activities come to a standstill. Actually, you know, in 2016, heavy rains caused flood in several districts of Assam, including Barpeta, Dhubri, Jorhat, Dhemaji, Golaghat, Bongaigaon, Lakhimpur, Gwalpara, Dibrugarh, etc. The floods affected about 1.6 million people, and the Pobitora Wildlife Sanctuary and the Kaziranga National Park were flooded, which resulted in the drowning of about 300 animals, and around 80% of the Kaziranga National Park was under water. So it was about the floods in Assam. Okay, now is the earthquake in Nepal. The earthquake that rocked Nepal, a Himalayan country, on 25th April 2015 was one of the most devastating disasters that led to a huge economic and loss of life and property. Its experience was near the village of Lamjung, approximately 80 kilometers northwest of Kathmandu, Nepal's capital. And you know, the magnitude of the earthquake was 7.8 on the Richter scale. 7.8. It is devastating. Effect of this such type of earthquake is devastating. It was also felt in several surrounding countries, including India, China, Bhutan, and Bangladesh. So that's all for today. In my next class, I'll go through the causes and impact of Nepal earthquake and the oil spills cases of oil spill cases of USA. Okay, so bye for today, and you all stay safe.